Hi, everybody. I'm Alyce-Kay Ruckelhaus from Threshold of Hineni and the Widow Ruckelhaus, and I wanted to share with you what's on tap on my channel this week. So this isn't on the Widow Ruckelhaus channel. I haven't been really putting anything up there lately, but I'm hoping to get to doing that soon, sometime. I'm not sure when, but this is on the Alyce-Kay Ruckelhaus channel, and it's more of my like Bible-related type and Christian related stuff. So anyway, so Monday, and these are already recorded, they're already scheduled, so hopefully everything will just go smoothly and this is what will be up. So Monday we're going to be working on the Now It Will Spring Forth Bible study. It's not really a Bible study, it's almost more like a devotional type of thing, maybe a combination between that and Bible studies. And what we're doing right now is we're looking at the verses that are used in the novel. This is the workbook, the study guide. The novel looks just like this, except it's thicker. You can get the novel for free. Just look at any of the videos for this and you'll see where you can click to get the novel free as an ebook. You can buy it as a paperback. You can get the workbook if you want to, and there's a link for that, or you can just get like a notebook or a journal, and I'm reading the questions, so you don't really need to have the workbook, but if you'd like to, that's great, and it helps me if you buy it too. So that's always great. So we're not going to be having the coloring overview right now, where we're coloring the Bible stories and I'm telling you about the story and how it can apply to your life and how it fits with the rest of the Bible. Right now I'm kind of like moving where I'm recording those, so it'll be a couple more weeks probably before I'll be doing any of those. So I have two of these for this week though. So on Monday I'm planning to do this, and the theme for Monday is when God asks you to do something totally crazy. And then I've also got it on Thursday, and the theme for that one is that God has a plan for you and it will happen. Okay, then Tuesday, in my Pray Surf Go group, we're starting to talk about ministry and about how you can start a ministry. And that doesn't have to be something formal. It doesn't have to be something that you get a 501k for, a nonprofit status, or even that you have to have a name for it. You know, if you're just like sowing things that you're giving to people, or you're just going and sweeping sidewalks or something, whatever. It doesn't have to be something quote unquote official, but just a way that you can be Jesus' hands and feet here on this earth helping people. And so last week, I talked with my mom about how she has started different ministries and how she goes about looking at that. And she's got something that she's looking at right now, so she shared about that. And then this week, she and I kind of talk together on a video about different ideas for helping elderly, disabled, grieving, or single parents, because we have experience with all of those things. We're both elderly, disabled. I'm kind of disabled. We're both, you know, grieving. We both lost our husbands in the last few years. She just lost hers in the last few months. And I've been a single parent. So we talk in that video about things that you probably wouldn't think of. I never would have thought of them if I wasn't in that situation. And so ways that you can help people, and those kinds of things can be your ministry or even something that you can do as a family, because a lot of these things are great things to do with kids. Then on Wednesday, since I had talked last week about what it means when Catholics say that they're praying to a saint or to Mary. That's not what Protestants usually think. It's not what I thought when I was a Protestant anyway. It's very different. And so I thought that this week I would share some of my personal experiences with that and how that has really helped me and made a difference in my life. And then Thursday, of course, there's the other one of these studies on God Has a Plan for You. And then on Friday, I always do my Chaplet of Divine Mercy. So those will all be posted. I think they're supposed to be like about 7:30 or so each morning, except for the chaplet. I post that at 12 or 12:30 around noon. And that's all on Eastern time. So anyway, I hope that you enjoy those, and you know, let me know if you have any comments or any requests or anything, especially questions that my mom and I can answer, or that I can answer about like Catholic things. Because what I'm trying to do right now with that is just kind of there are a lot of misperceptions on both sides. There are a lot of things that Catholics think about Protestants that are really funny too. And so I'm just kind of trying to share some of that right now, because most of my viewers are Protestant. I'm sharing more about like what these Catholic things really mean, so that you can know that. But if I get more Catholic viewers, then I'll probably share about what Protestants really mean with their things and just try to kind of help people understand and not have these misconceptions. So if you have any questions about that, or especially also if you have a topic that you would like prayed for with the chaplet on Fridays, I'm always open to suggestions for that. Okay, so anyway, I hope that you enjoyed this all. I've really had a lot of fun doing it. It was great having some time this week to get that done ahead of time. All right, I love you all. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.